Hello students, now we will do today the addition of rational numbers. What rules we have to follow while doing the addition of rational number? You know the rules of addition of fractions and you also know the rules of addition of integers. So both the rules will be applied here for addition of rational numbers. See how if you are getting a number like minus 3 upon 5 plus 7 upon 5. So, as in the fractions, what we are doing? We are having the common denominator. So, what we are doing? We are taking the denominator as common and we are adding the numerators, right? But here, in the numerator, what we are having integers. And you know how to do the addition in the integers? Minus 3 plus 7 will give you how much? 4. So, 4 upon 5. Okay? So, here you have used the rules of addition of fraction, and in the numerator when you are adding, then you got the integers. So we have used the rules of addition of integer. Same in case if you are having, suppose 5 upon 7 plus minus 2 upon or 2 upon minus 7 if you are getting, suppose like this. Then if you are getting negative sign in the denominator, so what is the first step we have to do? First, we have to make the denominator positive. So, this question will change to 5 by 7. This minus will come in the numerator. So, minus 2 upon 7. We have already done this. If we multiply in 2 upon minus 7 by minus 1 in the numerator and the denominator, so what will get? 2 into minus 1 will give you how much? Minus 2. And minus 7 into minus 1 will give you how much? 7. So, we have transformed the negative sign in the numerator. So now here again we are having the common denominator, so we have taken 7 as common, 5 plus minus 2, that is how much? 3. 3 upon 7 will be your answer. Okay, now if you are having the rational numbers in which you are having different denominators, so what you are doing in the fraction, we are making the denominators common by taking the LCM. So here also you will do the same thing. You have to take the LCM of 3 and 7 because these are the denominators and the LCM will go for 21. So again, how you will do? Minus 2 by 3 plus 4 by 7 will be equal to. Denominator will go by LCM, that is 21. So in 3 what we have to multiply? 3, 7 is 21. So in minus 2 we have to multiply it by 7. And 7, 3 is 21. So in 4, what you have to do? 4 into 3. The same process we are following what you have done in the fractions addition, right? Now see what you got. 7 into minus 2. So 7 into minus 2 is how much? Minus 14 and plus. 4, 3 is 12. So here in the numerator you can see, you have to follow the rules of the integers also. So that is the combination you are having. Minus 14 plus 12 will give you how much? Minus 2 upon 21. This will be your answer. Okay. Now, additive inverse of a rational number. For every rational number, P upon Q. Any rational number is there in the form of P upon Q. We know that rational number is in the form of P upon Q. So, there exists a minus P upon Q such that P upon Q plus minus P upon Q is equal to 0, and that is also equal to minus P upon Q plus P upon Q. By this statement, like if you see for this much, what this statement is saying, for the additive inverse of P by Q is minus P by Q. Additive inverse of P by Q. Additive inverse of P by Q is minus P by Q, and additive inverse of minus P by Q is P by Q. And this statement tells you that minus of minus P by Q is equal to how much? P by Q. Also, you can see through examples, what is the additive inverse? additive inverse means what should be added in the rational number so that to make the result as 0. As you can see here, what should be added in P by Q? So that to make the result as 0. So that number will be said to be the additive inverse of the given rational number. See, for example, you are having the number like, the number has been given, suppose the rational number 3 upon 9. So what should be added in 3 upon 9 to make the answer as 0? So obviously what you will write? 3 plus 3 by 9 plus minus 3 by 9 will be equal to 0. So additive inverse of 3 by 9 is minus 3 by 9. And if the number has been given like this, what is the additive inverse of minus 3 by 9? Then obviously what you will say? 3 by 9 minus 3 by 9 is 0. So I have to add plus 3 by 9 and the answer will be 0. So additive inverse of minus 3 by 9 will become 3 by 9. Okay? And hence, you can say that additive inverse, what is additive inverse? Just changing the sign, because I told you P upon Q is the rational number, then negative of that rational number is the additive inverse. And in place of this, if minus 3 by 9 is there, this is the rational number, 3 by 9, minus 3 by 9 is the rational number given, then the additive inverse of this should be minus of minus 3 by 9. And minus of minus 3 by 9, what we have calculated here, additive inverse of minus 3 by 9 is how much? 3 by 9, means this is the additive inverse, so this should be equal to 3 by 9, okay? Now, next topic we are having is subtraction of rational number. Now see, if P upon Q and R upon S are two rational numbers, then P upon Q minus R upon S, means we have to subtract R upon S from P upon Q, that will be equal to P upon Q plus minus R upon S. What is minus R upon S? Means subtraction is there. So what we have to do? We have to add the rational number by the additive inverse of the rational number to be subtracted. This number has to be subtracted. So we have to add the additive inverse of this number. So additive inverse of R upon S is what? Minus R upon S. Right? So see, for example, if you have to subtract 5 by 9 from minus 2 by 9. Means from minus 2 by 9 we have to subtract. So first number we will write minus 2 by 9. And subtraction we have to do. So minus 2 by 9 minus 5 by 9. Right? So subtraction we have to do. So subtraction will be equal to what? Minus 2 by 9 plus additive inverse of the number to be subtracted. Subtract this 5 by 9 from minus 2 by 9 means this number has to be subtracted. So what is the additive inverse of 5 by 9? Obviously additive inverse of 5 by 9 is minus 5 by 9. Right? And addition you know how to do. The base is common and numerators what we are having? Minus 2 plus minus 5. Right? And for the integers rule also you know, two negative integers are there, so this both can be added with the negative sign. So your answer will be minus 7 by 9. Okay? Now you have to subtract minus 3 by 4 from minus 11 upon 12. So from has been written, so from 11 upon 12 you have to subtract. So subtraction sign, what you have to subtract? Minus 3 upon 4. Right? So what I told you, whatever number is there, first number is same as it is. And then we are doing the addition. We are doing the addition of the number to be subtracted. Additive inverse of the number to be subtracted. So what is the additive inverse of minus 3 by 4? Additive inverse of minus 3 by 4 is plus 3 by 4. So you write plus 3 by 4. Right? And now LCM for 12 and 4 will go for 12 only, you know. So 12 will remain like this only. It is already having 12, so minus 11. Nothing to be multiplied in this. Plus 4, 3 is 12, so 3 into 3 you have to do. So what you got? Minus 11 plus 9 upon 12. And minus 11 plus 9 is how much? Minus 2. Because this is bigger in numerical value, is bigger, 11 is greater, so minus 10 will be there, just following the rules of the integer. Minus 2 upon 12, and both
r can be divided by 2, so lowest term will go for 2 1s are 2 and 2 6s are 12, so minus 1 upon 6 will be your answer. Yes, now next topic is multiplication of rational numbers. If p upon q and r upon s are two rational numbers, then p upon q multiplied by r upon s will be equal to numerators will be multiplied by numerators and denominators will be multiplied by denominators. Means you are just following the rules of the fraction. If you are getting a negative numbers, then we have to follow the integers law also. Like for example, if you have a number like 2 upon 7 multiplied by minus 3 upon 8. So what you will do? 2 multiplied by minus 3 and 7 multiplied by 8. Okay? So 3 2s are 8, 6 minus 6 upon 7 8s are 56. But this is not in the lowest term. Both number can be divided by 2. So you have to divide by 2 to get the answer in the lowest term. So what answer you get? Minus 3 upon 2 2s are 4 and 2 8s are 16. But this is one method. But more easy method is what? See one more. As we have done in the multiplication of fraction also. If the question is 2 by 7 multiplied by minus 3 upon 8. So we know that we have to multiply the numerators and we have to multiply the denominators also. But before going for the multiplication, we can check that either the numerator and the denominator can be cancelled down. See, here 2 is there, here 8 is there. So 2 1s are 2 and 2 4s are 8. We can do the cutting over here only. So what will be the answer? Minus 3 into 1, that is minus 3, and 7 4s are 8, 28. So we can follow this method for the easy one, because if we are doing the cutting in the initial stage only, so answer is automatically coming in the lowest term. We don't have to search for the lowest term, okay? Now, if you are having a number like 2 1 by 3 multiplied by minus 9 by 14, so what rule we are following always? Whenever we are having a number in the mixed one, so we have to turn up that into improper one. So what the first step is? 3 2s are 6 plus 1, 7. 7 upon 3 multiplied by minus 9 upon 14. So that is equal to 7 into 9 upon 3 into 14. You can see here 7 1s are 7 and 7 2s are 14. Right? 3 and 9 also can get cancelled. So 3 1s are 3 and 3 3s are 9. So we got the answer as, but negative sign was also there. I have missed that. This is negative. So the answer will come with minus 3 only. So minus 3 into 1 will give you minus 3 and upon 2. So your answer will be, because the question is having the mixed one, so you can turn up with the negative sign with the improper mixed one also. Minus will remain here. 2 1s are 2 and 1 is left. So 2 1 by 2 will be your answer. Sorry, 1 1 by 2 will be your answer. Okay. Now comes the reciprocal of rational number. If p upon q is non-zero rational number, then there exists q upon p such that p upon q into q upon p will give you how much? 1. For example, if the number you are having a rational number 2 upon 7, right? So what number should be multiplied in this so that the answer is 1? So obviously, what if the reciprocal just reverse the position of the numerator and the denominator? What you will get? Denominator will become numerator and numerator will become denominator. So both can be cancelled down and the answer will be 1. If you are having a negative rational number, suppose minus 11 upon 19. So again, when you will multiply, so what will the reciprocal of a negative rational number? Negative sign will be there, because negative negative will give you positive, because we want a positive one. And the reciprocal of this number, again change the position. So minus 19 upon 11 will give you 1. Okay. Also see that some important points you have to notice for this. What the important point you have to notice? Reciprocal of a rational number is also known as the multiplicative inverse. Reciprocal is same as multiplicative inverse of the number. They both are the same terms. Reciprocal of the rational number will be same as the multiplicative inverse. Like if I ask about 2 by, what is the multiplicative inverse of 2 by 7? So it is 7 upon 2. And what is reciprocal of 2 upon 7? Then also 7 upon 2. The other name is multiplicative inverse. Then 0 has no reciprocal. 0 has no reciprocal. Why? See, or you can say 0 has no reciprocal, or reciprocal of 0 is not defined, because there is no number. There exists no number. Any number is there, so that when you multiply it by 0 by any number and the answer will be 1. No, there exists no number in which 0 can be multiplied and the answer will be 1, because 0 multiplied by any number will give you answer always the 0. So there exists no number, hence 0 has no reciprocal. Okay, and then see, so one more important point, reciprocal of 1. Reciprocal of 1. What will be the reciprocal of 1? What should be multiplied in 1? What should be multiplied in 1 to get the answer as 1? Obviously 1 only. So reciprocal of 1 is 1 only. Right? And what is the reciprocal of minus 1? What should be multiplied in minus 1 to get the answer as 1? Because this is negative, so we need one negative sign and 1 only. So reciprocal of minus 1 is minus 1. And reciprocal of 1 is 1. Only these two are the numbers which are reciprocal of itself. So 1 and minus 1 are reciprocal of itself. Not for 1 you are writing the reciprocal of 1 is minus 1. No, reciprocal of 1 is 1 and reciprocal of minus 1 is minus 1. Okay. Now, division of rational numbers. If P upon Q and R upon S not equal to 0, means R upon S is a non-zero rational number. Are two rational numbers, then P upon Q divided by R upon S will be equal to P upon Q multiplied by S upon R. Means whenever we are having the division of two rational numbers, then we have to multiply the dividend by the reciprocal of the divisor. As we are doing in the fractions also, same here also we have to do. So 4 upon 9 dividend will be same, and division is there, so we will multiply the dividend by the reciprocal of the divisor. What is the reciprocal of this number? Minus 5 by 7. It will be minus will remain, because negative rational number is having negative reciprocal. So minus will remain there only, and 5 upon 7 will become 7 upon 5. Now multiplication rules we are knowing. Numerator will be multiplied by numerator and denominator by denominator. You can see nothing is getting cancelled, so directly you will multiply. 7 4s is 28, so minus 28, and 9 5s is 45. So this will be your answer. Okay. Now see the other example. Minus 1 6 by 7 divided by minus 7. Again we are having in the mixed one, so we will turn up into improper. So what will be the answer? Minus will remain here only. 7 1 is 7 plus 6. 7 plus 6 is how much? 13 upon 7 divided by minus 7. But when division is there, so what we are doing? Dividend is multiplied by the reciprocal of the divisor. And what is the reciprocal of minus 7? Reciprocal of minus 7 is minus 1 upon 7. I think you remember, if nothing is there in the denominator, as we have done in the fraction, what was there? 1 was there. So reciprocal of minus 7 upon 1 will give you minus 1 upon 7. So you can see nothing is getting cancelled. So minus 13 multiplied by minus 1 will give you how much? Positive 13. And 7 7s is 49. So this will be your answer. Okay. Now see one more example. Minus 1 upon 10 divided by minus 8 upon 5. So again, dividend will be multiplied by the reciprocal of the divisor. So reciprocal of divisor is how much? Minus 5 upon 8. Okay. So you can see here numerator and denominator, it can get cancelled. So 5 1s is 5 with minus sign because it is negative, and 5 2s is 10. Now minus 1 into minus 1 will give you how much? 1. And 2 8 is 16. So 1 upon 16 is your answer. So today we have done all the operations like addition, subtraction, multiplication, division of rational numbers. So go through the video properly. Okay. Thank you.